Most of the people I meet assume that I've been an athlete my entire life. They have no idea that I started this whole thing when I was 38 years old. I was thick and overweight, but I was afraid my entire life, as long as I can remember, that I was gonna be fat, thick, and out of shape and die young. Always thought that. And at 38, I discovered CrossFit. I was invited to a CrossFit class, and that 38-year-old Jason Grubb went on to become now a two-time CrossFit Games champion. So I thought I'd share with you the steps I took that took me from a thick, overweight, scared human being to a CrossFit Games champ. Let's jump in. So start with the basics. The first dramatic change that I made was starting to pay attention to what I ate and what I was shoveling in my face every day. My typical day of eating at 38 when I started was like a bowl of cereal followed by lunch, and lunch was like leftover pizza or leftovers from dinner the night before, leftover lasagna, leftover pasta, something like that. And I would often add bread to that because I was always starving. So I might, you know, toast up some bread, add some garlic to it, make it garlic bread. That's fine. Some breakfasts instead of a big giant bowl of cereal. Grape nuts was my favorite, by the way. Another favorite was peanut butter toast. So like 4 pieces of white bread with butter and peanut butter. Like there is nothing on the planet better than that. Late afternoon, I'd start snacking, maybe like a half a bag of chips at like 4. Maybe before that, or maybe would have gone on a run or something like that, or on a jog to try to maintain some level of fitness. And I'll talk about that in a minute. But then I'd eat some chips or something like that in the afternoon. Then at dinner, whatever it was for dinner, often pizza 2 or 3 nights a week. We'll just call it that. Then I would go on to drinking beer, 2, 3, 4 IPAs. That was standard every single night. And all of that, plus maybe a bowl of ice cream or a bag of chips, made me a fluffy human being. And I was surprisingly, at 38, I wasn't morbidly obese. You know, I weighed an extra 10, 15 pounds, but it was just fluffy and it didn't feel good. Like I felt like crap. So first change, changed the way I ate. I had a friend that recommended, he's like, dude, you're just eating straight up carbs. All you're eating is carbs. And I was like, okay, so I'll make this change. So I switched over to eating eggs and broccoli for breakfast every day, literally turned on the dime, just went for it. And I'd often make enough eggs and broccoli to have that for like lunch. So I would just do that for 2 meals a day. And it was right around that exact same time that I started CrossFit. My eating journey started just before CrossFit. So I was under eating for sure at the time. For dinner, I'd have a regular dinner and I'd have, you know, a couple of IPAs every single night. But then I started CrossFit. And the reason I started CrossFit, besides the fact that I had a young baby at home and I wanted to be like healthy into the future, but I had no idea. I really had no idea what I was gonna do. But I did jump into a CrossFit class and I literally had my ass handed to me by everyone in the class. And I thought of myself as a slightly fit human being. Like I thought that I had, from jogging, you know, 2 or 3 times a week, I jog like 5 miles. I thought I was somewhat fit. Literally was not. I was not fit. And I got destroyed by everyone in this CrossFit class. And this wasn't like a young, hip class full of CrossFit Games athletes. This was like moms and dads, people older than me, like thicker than me, and they all killed me. And that was crazy. So I jumped in to fitness. And so I started to work out 6 days a week. Like I went all in. So if you have any experience with going all in on CrossFit, you know that that's a really good way to get injured. So I literally went to CrossFit 6 days a week from the day I started, like fall of 2013, 6 days a week, never taking a day off, period. And what happened? Of course, by like week 3, I bruised a rib or like pulled a muscle in my rib. And within a month, an old rotator cuff injury in my shoulder was killing me. Like I couldn't clean, I couldn't jerk, I couldn't put weight overhead, I couldn't do wall balls because catching the wall ball hurt so much. So at that point, honestly, I slowed down my progress a little bit. I knew I was getting fitter, but I started doing crossover symmetry every day to help my shoulder. My rib eventually got better. I don't know what happened. I think there was a rowing workout where literally I didn't want to let these guys that were like not as, like they were fitter than me. I wanted to win. And I pulled like crazy on the rower. And I think I bruised my rib with a rower. Anyway, I'm slightly competitive. So over time, shoulder started to feel better. And after about 6 months, I was getting fitter. Like my body was changing. One, I was eating better, at least 2 meals a day. You know, breakfast was pretty low carb, protein, vegetables. Lunch was protein, vegetables. Dinner was whatever. Still drinking lots of beer. But I was making progress. And there was one day when I was doing this running workout. And I remember like looking down at the ground in front of me. You know, the sun was behind me, shadows in front of me, and the shadow had shoulders. And it was the first time I was like, holy crap, are those my shoulders? Like, is that me? So obviously I was starting to get fit and I was really enjoying it. And those two components will make you a healthy human being. Literally, by just controlling your diet by at least two meals a day, that'll get you going big time. Like, compared to eating what I was eating, switching those two meals was a dramatic change for my body. And by doing fitness every day, just following a CrossFit class, the thing that made me a competitor, someone who was hungry to do better and to become a CrossFit Games champion, or at least have the idea of that, is that I'm just built for competition. I've always been competitive. It's in my DNA. It's part of like my personality profile. I'm an Enneagram 3. If you haven't done an Enneagram test, Google Enneagram personality test. I'm type 3. If you want to look that up, that is me. Highly competitive. And at the CrossFit gym that I was at, there was the owner of the gym. He was a competitive athlete. And he, man, this guy, his whole life was an athlete. He was a really good CrossFitter. And I just wanted to get as good as Keith at the time. Just wanted to get as good as him. And there was a certain point, 9 or 10 months in, when I started beating Keith in workouts. And I loved that competitive. I loved the leaderboard every day at the gym. Like that got me, guys. It just did. And then I did a CrossFit competition. They were talking about it. I overheard them talking about it at the gym. And I was like, what is this competition? They're like, yeah, it's like 3 or 4 workouts. It's a competition. Like, you know, there's winners and stuff. And I was like, oh, I don't want to try that. So I went and did that first CrossFit competition, and I just didn't want to get last, and I got like 6th place, but not far off the podium against like 20-year-olds. That was it. I was hooked. I was like, oh, I like this. I like this a lot. Okay, let me figure this out with regards to the CrossFit Games. Like, I'm turning 40. There's some sort of qualifier stuff. Let me discover more about this. So I had my sights set on the CrossFit Games. It was a bucket list thing of mine. Like, I wanted to get there. I'd actually opened my own gym, and now I was training clients and I was working out on my own. And in 2015, I tried to qualify for the CrossFit Games. And I mean, really, I didn't really have muscle ups that year. So that year, you know, there was muscle ups in the CrossFit Open, and I got better at them, but I didn't make the age group qualifier that year. And then in 2016, I did qualify for the age group qualifier. And if you're new to CrossFit, or if you're not sure what I'm talking about, it takes 2 qualifiers to narrow down masters or age group athletes, those above 35 or below age 18, to get to the CrossFit Games. There's a CrossFit Open, and that has got hundreds of thousands of participants worldwide. And then there's the age group qualifier, where historically they would take the top 200 in each age group, and that would be the second round of qualification. Then they would take the top 20 from there to get to the CrossFit Games. The rules are slightly different now. They allow the top 10% to go to the age group qualifier right now, but it doesn't really matter. It's a similar process. So in 2016, I made it to the age group qualifier, and I didn't come close. I did the workouts, didn't even come close to qualifying. 2017, I took life really seriously. I really wanted to get there. I think I took 50th, somewhere around there, and top 20 got to go. Here was the big problem. I was still eating like garbage, and I was still drinking tons of beer. My body had changed. I was under eating. If we just take a look at my macros, I was under eating breakfast and lunch, gorging at dinner, and drinking lots of beer. And even with all of that, I was still in a caloric deficit. So aesthetically, I looked great and I looked fit. It wasn't what a CrossFit Games athlete would do in order to qualify. This isn't how they live. This isn't how they eat, how they recover. I wasn't sleeping as well. Like, I was sleeping 5-6 hours a night. That's fine. No, not okay. So the mistakes I was making at the time that I think were the biggest mistakes with regards to not making it to the games in 2016, 2017. One, I wasn't eating enough food, and I was eating the wrong food. So the summer of 2017, I decided to remove grain from my diet altogether, to stop eating any kind of breads, anything like that. And my body fat percentage dropped, and I was eating all of my carbs via vegetables and paying attention to what I was eating. I was really trying to eat well. That was good. I actually felt that in my training, and I felt good about eating that way. I also changed my training. I was following a competitive track at the time that was made for, you know, athletes in their 20s, and it was way too much training. So I was overtraining. I was literally pounding my body to death, but not being effective in my workouts. So in my run for the CrossFit Games in 2018, I had changed my programming so that I wasn't doing quite as much volume, but what I was doing was very intentional, very intense, and very deliberate. I also started paying attention to mobility and recovery. It was around that time that I really realized that some of my limiting factors in moving well for what is required for the CrossFit Games, or even doing well, is I needed to be more mobile. My ankles, hips, shoulders, very immobile. So I really started working on that. At the time, I followed Ramwad, did a lot of stretching on my own, did a lot of mobility as part of my warm-up in order to get my body ready for working out. Started to sleep 7 or 8 hours a night. Total game changer. I would take naps on Sundays in order to just be part of that recovery on a rest day. Like, these were things I would never do, but I knew that I needed to do something in order to calibrate my body, to fine-tune my body to be a games athlete. And I dialed down my drinking. I realized that I couldn't be drinking IPAs like they're going out of business. So I really dialed that down. In fact, I stopped drinking almost altogether. I didn't drink for a couple of months there, but then I switched to having, you know, a glass of wine here and there, but really no beer. In fact, if you don't have beer for like 18 months and then you go back and drink a Bud Light, it's sweet nectar. Like, it's absolutely amazing. But the whole point is, like, I didn't drink, and then I had a Bud Light, and it was yummy. In 2018, went through the CrossFit Open, went through the age group qualifier, and I qualified for the CrossFit Games. And I decided to take a look at my nutrition to see what I was actually eating every day, like really track. And after tracking it for a week, I realized I was dramatically under eating. Like, I wasn't eating enough food. But yeah, my body looked great, but I was totally underfed. So I made an adjustment, started following specific macros that were appropriate for me as a competitive athlete, given the activity that I was doing. It was life-changing. Well, the first couple of weeks, I was just full all the time. Like, I couldn't believe I was supposed to be eating that much food. It was hard to eat that much food. Then I started to feel it in my body. My lifts got easier, workouts got better. Like, I had energy. It was absolutely insane. Got to the CrossFit Games in 2018. Nervous as all get out. As I got there, I made it to the Games. So nervous. Planned all my eating, and I did well. I was 42 years old at the time. You know, not the youngest in the age group. And I did well, and I got third. And that lit a fire in me, like, oh, I'm doubling down on this. And held on to that consistency, eating enough food an entire year, getting enough sleep, enough rest, enough recovery, not overtraining. 2019, I won. I won the whole thing. I was 43 years old and I won against some of the toughest competitors I could ever imagine. Stayed fairly consistent in 2020, then COVID happens. There's no games for us, that's fine. That made for a really long season going into 2021. Again, consistent eating, consistent nutrition, consistent training, really hard training up to the games. Got to win it again this year. The last thing I'm gonna say, guys, is that all of that will get you to the games. And that's great. To win the CrossFit Games takes a tremendous amount of imbalance. That's the only word that can come to mind, is that you're not balanced as a human being. Training becomes paramount. You start to become really narrow in your focus, and almost everything that you do, everything that I did, was about trying to get to and win the CrossFit Games or do well. Like, I didn't know I was gonna win, but I wanted to do really well. That narrow focus and that slight imbalance in my life, if I needed to train at 6 o'clock at night, I did. If it was 8 o'clock at night, I did. A number of times. When it came to eating, sleeping consistently, all of those things took priority. And that makes for a slight imbalance in my life. You know, I could go to the pool with the kids or do a training session. And oftentimes I'm torn. I'm trying to do everything and be everything I can for everybody. My clients, my business, my kids, everything. It's hard. So just know that, like, a run to win the CrossFit Games requires significant imbalance in your life. Now, I've always been imbalanced in whatever I'm doing. So that's not new to me, but I'm just sharing that with you, that it does take some sacrifice and some major dedication. That's how this 38-year-old thick guy became CrossFit Games champion twice. Been on the podium 3 times. I'm happy, proud about that. Can't wait to do it again next year. And if you need any help getting to your destination, whether that's losing 20 pounds or making a run for the CrossFit Games. Shoot me a DM, leave me a comment, connect with me. I help guys achieve their goals, big and small, all the time. I'd love to work with you. Also, if you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button, and we'll see you back here next time.